that he asked you. Then just now we're talking about your dad. I mean, apart from anything and everything, I mean, you're around 12 years. Your dad was only there. I remember at some stage he didn't go to work because he had to take you to a tournament. I think it was Future Champs, was it? Yeah. Everywhere you went, he stopped everything to take you through. The support from your parents, just to continue on that note, your dad having to quit his job because he wanted to make sure that you take your football seriously. I mean, what does that say to a Lyle that is now today playing in one of the biggest leagues in the world, that some man somewhere said, I must quit my job to make sure my son gets his career going?
Sorry, I look straight in front of you.
Oh, because I'm looking at that camera.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah.
So, that's weird. So my dad, is someone, is my dad, like you said, he quit his job to make sure that I can chase this dream. He's done it since I was young. Obviously, he was there, he sacrificed as well as my mother. Both of them played big roles. My mother had to still work while my dad was driving me around, and my sister. So, I think it was the perfect relationship. And it still is, and they're my biggest support structure. And whenever I feel things aren't going my way, when they are, they're the first people I try and contact. My parents are the reason I'm here. And I'll be eternally grateful for everything that they do. And like I said, I'm only 23 now. There's still a long way to go. So hopefully I can still keep on achieving and fighting for more dreams.
Just to follow up on that, looking at your family life now, the change that they've experienced since you reached the highest, how much has Lyle changed their life at home? You don't have to tell us how much you give them.
They've changed my life, no. They're the ones who sacrificed for me. They're the ones who pushed me into football and make sure that, I'm always at training, I'm always playing games, so I don't think it's fair to say I changed their lives. They changed mine.
From a footballing perspective, this venue, what has it mean to you?
It's home. It's home. It's a stadium I've got tattooed on my body. I'm from Noordgesig, about 2 kilometers away from here. We used to walk here to come and watch Pirates play midweek games. A lot of the time, my father, my uncles, all our family are Pirates supporters. So even to be able to play was a great honor for me. And obviously, it's a club that are all dear to me forever because, like I said, it's my neighborhood club and the team I always grew up supporting. So playing here is always special.
I guess that brace against Liberia says a lot, scoring for your country here.
Yeah, it's nice. It was the second time. The only time I score for the country in South Africa is here, so it's a good thing.
Lyle, I wanted to ask you about the Premier League, just compared to you've played in France, Belgium, Portugal. Coming up against the defenders there, it's known as a sort of a robust league. Have you also had to maybe work on your body in terms of bulking up?
Yeah, definitely.
What is it like coming up against defenders that side?
Yeah, definitely. I think everything has to change when you step up. Like I said, you play against treble winners, Champions League winners, you play against World Cup winners, and people are obsessed with the game, obsessed with improving, and if you aren't, you struggle a bit. So, I've had to bulk up. I don't know if it's visible. But definitely had to bulk up. It's a tough league. You can't make too many mistakes, otherwise you're punished, but I'm enjoying it so far, and I think with the young team that we have, we can only grow and learn more in this league. I think especially the first three games were three tough games against three world-class opponents, but I believe in my team, I believe in my players, and like I said, it's still a long season ahead.
And there's a contrast between your individual form and the club form. So you guys are from the local startup. Is there, I know it's still early as you say, but is there maybe that moment of panic buttons a bit to say, hey, there may be trouble here?
I mean, three games in the season. I don't think pressing panic buttons is anything different than, there's no need to panic. I think, like I said, played three of the toughest teams in the league. We've got a good game coming up on Monday, and then that's going to be an important one for us, but first need to focus on tomorrow with the national team.
And Lyle, I saw you kneeling and praying. Does that come from the family, or is it something that you've developed on your own? And how important is it in your career?
Yeah, it comes from the family, you know. It comes from everyone who I love, who I hold dear to me. And just over time, you know, your relationship grows with the Lord. And it's something that's dear to me, and I do.
Lyle, okay, for a striker.
Guys, I'm going to take the last three questions for Lyle.
Just for a striker, Lyle, I mean, looking at how the previous match ended goalless, what does it say to you coming into this team that before the match we were talking about yourself, about your Zakes, you know, players that are banging in goals left, right and centre, but now the match ends on a 0-0, the goalless draw. What does it say to you guys as strikers, if you can speak on behalf of the collective that was playing forward?
Well, I think it was a game where there wasn't a lot of clear-cut chances, and there's not much we can say. We can't win every game 5-0 or score in every game. We know that it's not going to happen. So just to stay patient, to focus on what happened in the last game, and then go into the next game.
What face your question?
Okay, thanks. Now, you just one of the. I'm Boniface. One of the foreign-based Bafana Bafana players. I don't know. Do you think it's important for Bafana to have more players or foreign coming to play for them? And what message do you have for local players about maybe dreaming of playing outside?
I do think it's important for Bafana Bafana to have more players playing overseas. And I think with time we'll get there. Like I said, we've got a young group, a core group, and I think there's a fair amount of guys who do play overseas. And a few guys who aren't here now, like Bongo and Blom, and who've been here before. Cassius as well, who's made a good move for himself. And I think it's important for us to go and to test ourselves there, so that when we come back, we can bring back different experiences to the national team and different identities of football. I think that we'll grow in that way as a team. So I think it's super important for us to have foreign-based players, and obviously trying to have more players play in the highest leagues possible, because that's the only way we will improve as a team. But I think that the steps are there, the foundation is being laid, and we can only grow from here.
Final question is from someone that hasn't asked. Who'd like to ask a question?
Lyle, you spoke about Steven Pinheiro, spending time with him. But growing up as a striker, was there somebody in South Africa that you looked up to? Did you said, I want to be?
So overall, general, like the role model in South Africa and the focal point was Benny. You know, what he's achieved, winning the Champions League, finishing second in the Golden Boot race in the Premier League with Blackburn. What he's achieved, he's always been the guy, you know, that I've looked up to. But just like in South African football, like I said, I used to come to Orlando Stadium quite a bit. So at that time, it was Kermie and Gabuza. So those are the two guys I fell in love with, as well as Castro at Sundowns at the time. So, Castro is not South African, but referencing to South African guys, Benny is always that guy. For any striker in South Africa, and then, like I said, Kermie and Gabuza as well.